Can you help me out with question number 39 here?
Of course. Is this the problem?
Yes, I don't really understand what to do here.
No problem. Let's take this to the blackboard. The key concept here is optical isomerism.
Got it. But how can I tell if an isomer is optically active?
Optically active compounds require a chiral carbon atom. A chiral carbon is one that is bonded to four different groups.
Okay, awesome. That makes sense. So how do I apply that to solve this problem?
Let me walk you through the steps to solve this problem.
Okay, got it. Let me find the structures first.
Sure, no worries. Feel free to show me when you're done.
I found four carbon chain structures. Is that correct?
Close, but not quite. There are four structures, but you've made a small mistake in the third structure. Can you check your work again?
I can't actually find the mistake. Can you show it to me?
For sure. You added an extra hydrogen bond to the second carbon atom. I'm circling it now.
Oh, okay. Good catch. That's actually really helpful. Thank you. So I think this is where the chiral center is. Can you confirm?
Yes, here is the chiral center. Well done.
Remember the optically active isomer problem we were working on? Can you show me what the two chiral molecules actually look like?
Sure. Have a look at the molecular structure. I've created the molecular structures of the two optically active isomers, also known as enantiomers of 2-bromobutane.
Thanks for all your help, Astra.